Hi there, welcome to my demo on shaping and cooking sourdough pita bread. The first thing we're going to do is take our dough and divide it in half. This is going to start the shaping process. We want 16 equal portions. They should be around 65 grams each. Here I'm cutting it in half again. And then each quarter will be cut into quarters. Now I'm going to speed up a little bit and show you the rest of the shaping process. Okay, so on the next one, I'm going to slow it down. I'm going to show you exactly how I do it. Plenty of flour on the board, and start by pulling the top toward the center. Rotate and pull the top toward the center again. Do this all the way around until you have a nice tight little ball of dough. Okay, at this point, you're going to flip it over and use the outside of your hands to create tension across the top of the dough ball. You're bringing them down and in at an angle toward the work surface, rotating the ball as you go. This is going to create the tension across the top and make a nice tight little seam on the bottom. And now you have a nice little ball of dough that's perfectly round and perfectly tight. Okay, have your oven preheated to 550 degrees and have a baking stone in there. The next part of the process is actually rolling the dough. Use plenty of flour on your work surface so that the dough doesn't stick. And roll it into a nice round pancake about 1/8 of an inch thick. Here I'm going to speed up a little bit and get to the final product. And here it is, completely rolled out into a nice thin pita. You can see how easy it is to handle. It's still very strong. Okay, now you're going to stick that pita right onto the hot baking stone. And the process of cooking takes about 2 minutes at 550 degrees. And you can see it's going to start to bubble up. And as it's cooking, it's going to fill with hot steam, creating a little balloon. And there it goes. It's completely poofed. And at this point, you're going to want to flip it around a little bit just so it cooks evenly. Okay, here I am cutting one of the cooled pitas to show you how to open it. It's a very nice little pocket. You can use this small piece as a brace on the bottom if you're going to be making a pita sandwich of some sort. That adds a little extra layer, and fill it with whatever your favorite toppings are. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to check out my others and subscribe. Thanks!